Hey guys, how are you doing? I'm Anime Intensity and welcome back to my channel. Today we're actually having another manga first take where I talk about brand new manga series or series that have been released but I just started reading it, you know, like the first volume or so. It's not exactly a complete series review, but it's just like my first impressions, my first thoughts on cool new series. So today's series is actually kind of like Honey, I Shrunk the Kids and Alice in Wonderland at the same time. It's very weird because those two things, you would never put them together, but honestly, this manga is kind of like both of those things, but kind of deadlier, I guess you could say. More grim and more, I don't know, sometimes when I was reading, I was like, this is definitely not what I expected. And that manga is called Wonderland. So I actually have it right here. So this is volume one of Wonderland. I haven't read volume two yet. I'm not sure if volume two has been released either, so I'm clueless. But I finally got around to, reading volume one completely, and I can't wait to talk about it and review this first volume, which I gotta admit had a lot of crazy events going on. So yes, it's called Wonderland. Yes, our main character is in like an Alice in Wonderland outfit on the cover, and this manga is actually published by Seven Seas. I am used to Seven Seas publishing stories that take place in other worlds, or ghost girls, or monster girls, things like that, so I think that this fits perfectly in their lineup of manga. This is by Yugo Ishikawa, and the cover is something that instantly like drew me in when I first saw it, mainly because it does look kind of grotesque. It does look kind of like, you know, like dark. Ooh, like I love that kind of stuff. So I was like, I really want to check it out because it's not quite Alice in Wonderland. It's not quite Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. It's a little bit more deadly than that, like I said before. So our main character, her name is Yuko, and Yuko wakes up one day and she sees her dog. She's like, you really smell, and you know. That sounds very relatable to my everyday life, but that's the same thing I say to my dog. So she wakes up, she sees her dog. Her dog is huge and is really cute. I think it's like a sheepdog kind of dog. I absolutely love those things. It's like the dog from Ariel, you know? So, so cute. But she sees her dog. He is huge all of a sudden. She's like, I don't know what's going on. Am I dreaming? I better wake up now. And she's definitely not dreaming. That's the thing. So basically everybody, not just her, has now turned very, 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 very small. Which is crazy. Think about it. Like, waking up one day and just being like the size of a pencil or something. Even shorter than that. Even smaller than that. It's insane. And that's what happens to her. She thinks that she's in a nightmare, but she's not in a nightmare. She's in real life. And the thing is, like, you're like, oh, okay, it can't be that bad to be so tiny and just everything is going to be so huge and you can explore and have adventures. It's telling you, it's definitely not like Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. It's definitely not like that. It's just like, as we are introduced to the story, we see her dog, Poco. Like I said before, her dog is absolutely adorable. And Poco is very friendly. Thank God. Because, unfortunately, the other pet in her house is, I wouldn't say not friendly, but wants to play. And the cat wants to play with Yuko's family members. You know how cats are. When they want to play with something that is alive, that they will most likely end up really, like, hurt or dead. So that's what's going on in her poor house. She has this dog and she has this cat. She's friends with the dog. The cat, not so much. The cat wants to go after her like it went after her parents, and they are not in such great shape. But it's funny because even though they're trying to make the cat seem so like deadly and ferocious, which is right at the moment, yeah, I would want to avoid the cat too if I was that size. I still think it's kind of cute. I feel like the ways that animals act are just emulated really well in this manga. Like, I was like, wow, yeah, this is how a little cat would walk, or a little cat would behave, or, you know, this is how a dog would be, this is how they would interact. Like, I really enjoyed seeing how true to their actual behavior, it is displayed in the manga, because I was like, yeah, this is how they are in real life, and just seeing that in a manga is like, yes, I really enjoyed that. It's funny because I never knew that Japan had that many cats. I was like, but how many cats are there? There were just so many cats, especially towards the end of the volume, where there's just like a horde of cats. And I'm just like, but where did they come from? So I definitely did not estimate Japan's cat population to be that huge, but wow. There were so many cats and so many crows too. And those are the two major enemies against the humans, I guess you could say. They're the villains. Even though they're not really bad, they're just kind of doing what nature wants them to do, you know? It's not their fault, but they are the two main, like, factors that are, like, killing humans. So it's kind of dark and kind of gross seeing some of these things. You're like, oh, whoa, like, oh, like, I don't want to see a human get eaten by a crow. Like, it's really cool, though. It's really cool seeing what would happen if we were so tiny like that. But honestly, I liked this volume of manga. I liked the storyline. I like Yuko. Yuko is very creative, and she, I gotta admit, to think of that box cutter thing and to make a pouch for her phone and to go find food for Poco and everything. She is very, very smart and creative. I think she will make it. She ends up encountering, you know, on her way to find Poco some food, she finds this girl who is speaking like another language. She's dressed in like armor. The armor was from some toy that she found, but this girl calls herself Alice, so now you know why it's like Wonderland, why she's dressed up as Alice, and she actually does dress up as Alice in this volume. But who is she? Is she good? Is she evil? I don't know. Where does she come from? Who knows? So I definitely need to check the next volume out to see what is up with Alice, because I have no idea who she is. I liked this first volume, and the fact that they contain this whole city, they're like, you guys are not, you know, we've received numerous phone calls that are pretty bad, and now we're just gonna quarantine the whole city. Nobody's getting in, nobody's getting out. So there is definitely some kind of danger, some kind of force that happened in this town, and now they don't want it to spread. According to this girl, Yuko's friend, Yuko's friend said that she was perfectly fine where she was. So I don't know what exactly is happening in this town, but there's something crazy going on. And it's not only just nature that's against the humans, but it's also humans against humans. You know, when Yuko goes to find food for Poco, these people in the supermarket are like, hey, you're not coming in here. Nope, you're not bringing this dog in here so we can eat us. She's like, my dog is friendly. And the dog is friendly. And I really hope that the dog survives throughout the entire manga, because I really, really grew to like Poco, because Poco's really cute and just like really supportive character. And maybe he doesn't know that he's being very supportive, but he's being very supportive. All I can say after reading this manga is that I'm thankful that I am not that same size. It really takes the subject of being tiny and makes it so much more dangerous. Like, for example, Arrietty. I don't know how many people have seen Arrietty. Yes, there's some danger, like once again with the cat and the bird, some things like that, but there's never any bloodshed. There is bloodshed in here. It just takes it to the next level. I can't say that the story is too great all of a sudden, you know, like it's not too amazing yet. It's only the first volume. But I want to see where it goes. So I think that if you are up for a fun read, if you like stories that are a little quirky, a little bit different, a little bit, I don't know what, not too focused on the plot itself, I think you should definitely check out Wonderland. It's a pretty cool manga, and it takes that whole concept, like I said before, to the next level. So I do recommend it if you like this kind of stuff. It is older teen, so yeah, there is blood. There's bloodshed in here, mostly due to cats and crows, but overall, I thought it was a pretty fun, quick read. I don't expect too much out of it. I think that's how, you know, if you go into the story, don't expect too much out of it. Just read it for the fun and read it for the thrill and read it for the danger. But past that, I haven't seen too much out of Wonderland. I wonder if that will change. I wonder if there will be character development. I felt like this was a little fast-paced, maybe too fast-paced for the first volume, but let's just see how that changes with future volumes. And I'm excited to check it out. I thought the first volume, while not the best volume ever, was still an entertaining read. So if you've checked it out already, or you want to check it out, feel free to comment below. Let me know how you felt or feel about the whole concept of Wonderland. Thank you guys so much for watching. Totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you liked this video, and I will see you guys next time.